You now have a better sense of the Git workflow, but now we need to build on your understanding of what Git is doing under the hood. In this video, we'll revisit some of the commands we learned and discuss why you want to be selective about what items you add to your repository when you make changes to your project. We'll also go over how Git stores our snapshots, or more correctly, our commits. The more you understand how Git works, the better equipped you'll feel about using it. Let's go ahead and get started. In this lesson, I want to create a repository that has a list of campus advisors. I want to include a README.md file and a text file called Campus Advisor List. The README will have instructions on how to add campus advisors to the Campus Advisor List.txt file. To do this, let's first open up Atom. I want to make a new directory, so let's open the command line by simultaneously clicking the Control and Tilde keys. Alternatively, if for some reason your command line does not open, hit the plus symbol at the bottom left corner. We're now in your home directory, which is shown by the tilde. I'm going to create a new project folder here, but you're welcome to place your project folder anywhere. I'll use the command mkdir and I'll call the project Campus Advisor List. From there, I want to enter this directory, so I'll use the bash command cd followed by Campus Advisor List. Once here, I want to initialize my Git repository using git init. Let's make sure my .git directory is present by typing the bash command ls-a, and I see it. Great. I now have a Git repository that does not have any commits of my work, so I have a clean slate to work with. Let's connect our project folder to our Atom session by going to File, Open, and then find your Campus Advisor List directory. The reason we want to do this is so that we can use our text editor alongside our command line for the same project. As I mentioned, I want to create a README.md file, so let's start there. On the command line, I can use the bash command touch followed by README.md. Now I can use git status to check on the state of my working directory. You'll notice that Git is aware that we added a new file, README.md, and it's untracked, meaning it is within our working directory. Let's go ahead and practice taking a snapshot of the current state of our project. Remember, we're in the working directory and we need to move our README.md into the staging area and then commit it to our local repository. So to get to the staging area, we use git add followed by README.md. We can check our status to ensure it is in the staging area, which it is. Then we can commit with a message add README.md. Great, we've made our first snapshot, which is our first commit. If we type git log, we'll notice that our commit is there. I want to introduce this diagram. This will help us map out what Git is actually doing under the hood. In our project, we have our first commit with our first recorded version of README.md. Let's go ahead and add some instructions to our README so folks know how to add their name to the Campus Advisor list. Let's open up our README.md file and edit it. I'll write the instructions as Campus advisors should open campusadvisorlist.txt and add their name and the school they teach at. Pretty simple instructions. Let's save this by either going to File Save, or depending on your computer, you can use the designated hotkeys, which in my case is Command S. And here I want us to use a new Git command, which is diff. This will show us the changes that we can add to the staging area at this point. Git is comparing the working directory with the staging area. So git diff, and you should see that our instructions are in our working directory, and Git recognizes that these can go into our staging area. Let's add these changes. Now let's try git diff again. Notice that nothing comes up. This is because there is nothing new to add to the staging area. Diff is helpful if you need to know what has changed since you started working. You might be asking, well, as I start to add more things to the staging area, how can I see what has changed? This is very simple. You can actually compare your staging area to your current local repository by using the command diff with dash dash staged. This is helpful because before you commit, you want to make sure that you're positive that you want to commit these changes. For now, let's add our campusadvisorlist.txt to our project. First, we'll create the file, touch campusadvisorlist.txt, and let's add it from our working directory to the staging area. So we'll use git add campusadvisorlist.txt. Okay, let's now use our status command for a moment to talk about something very important. You notice that we have README.md and campusadvisorlist.txt staged to be committed into our repository. Now, when it comes to taking a snapshot or a commit of your project, you want to make sure that when you commit, you're committing to one logical, functional piece of work. For instance, when you write your commit message, it shouldn't have and in the sentence at all. So for example, campusadvisorlist.txt and add instructions for README.md is not okay. There's actually too much going on here. We want our commits to focus on a single thing. When writing code, perhaps you're adding a new feature by changing multiple files. That's perfectly fine to be one single commit because your message can ultimately say, add blank or X functionality to my project. Now, if you worked on two features at once, it would be better to make two separate commits, one for X and one for commit Y. If you find yourself writing and in your commit message, it's a good hint that your commit may have too many things going on. Right. So in this case, I'm going to make a decision that I want to commit my instructions first, so I need to remove campusadvisorlist.txt from the staging area. You notice that Git actually gives you the instructions to do this under changes to be committed. You can take git reset head followed by the file name, which is campusadvisorlist.txt, and if we type git status, we'll now see that only README.md is in the staging area, and now I can actually go ahead and commit. Now, if we use git log, we'll have two commits, the creation of the README and the other commit with the instructions. You can use the up and down arrow keys to scroll through the git log if your command line is short. Remember, you can use Q to escape or quit out. Back to our diagram. This is what Git has done. It has created another version of README.md, but has kept the previous version in the other commit. This is done so that if you ever need to revert back to a previous version, Git has you covered. Git does this differently than some other version control systems. Some other version control systems actually only save the changes after every commit, whereas Git will actually create another version and save the old version as well. Let's go ahead and commit our campusadvisor.txt file now. And let's go ahead and revisit our diagram. This is what's happened now. Git has not only taken a snapshot of our new campusadvisorlist.txt, but during the commit, it has also taken a snapshot of README.md from the previous commit. Every time you commit, Git takes a snapshot of what all your files look like at the moment. To be clear though, Git is not a data hog in that it just keeps copying files over and over. Instead, if files are not changed during a certain commit, like README.md in this case, it'll store a link to the previous file it has stored. So in the diagram, during our third commit, we have a version 2 of README.md linking from our second commit as a reference. Git will continue this pattern as we add and change files over time. To recap, we have learned how to be selective with our commits when it comes to staging files. We can also use diff and diff --staged to see our changes to ensure we want to stage those changes or commit them. We also learned generally how Git stores our commits. There's a great deal still to learn, but remember that learning how to use Git effectively takes time, and there's always a way to revert your changes back to a previous version. That's the beauty of Git, and the number one reason why you shouldn't be afraid to use it.